to talk to you today about my journey of being diagnosed with breast cancer. The initial shock wasn't immediate. Actually, I found the tumor in my right breast taking a shower. It was so big that I found it through my washcloth. And I said, well, let me go to the doctor. And I went to the doctor. Everything was so speed. And I said, slow down, because I got a trip to go to. And literally, I stopped everything because I had a trip to go on. And when I came back, that's when they did the biopsy, rushing me from one doctor to another. And then 3 days later, I got the results. And at that time, I told Sister Crane about it, and my husband was out of town. And I remember walking down the hall, Sister Crane and the doctor, they knew each other because she's been doing this for a long time because she's also a survivor. And I remember in my head saying, you have cancer, you have cancer. And that's when the reality of me just slowing down in my head, everything started going at a slow pace. And when we get in the office and we sit down, I'm looking at them two laughing and talking, and then she just looked at me, and this look on her face, I'll never forget it. And she said, it's cancer. And I actually just froze. I froze there, and I couldn't say anything. I couldn't do anything. And I remember Sister Crane just talking and talking. And Sister Crane took it as not a big deal. We're gonna fight it. We're gonna deal with it. But I didn't know that until after we left. So she tells me that, we wrap it up. I walk out into the hallway with Sister Crane, and she looks at me and she says, we're gonna fight it, we're gonna beat it. And something else she said, but it was all in a fog. And I remember just being shocked, because those words to say, it is cancer, it's like, whoa. Now, I will say this, I never thought from that moment through my whole journey that I was going to die. It was just the fact that I had this disease and I didn't know what to do. I remember going to my car. I remember calling my husband, and I remember telling him that I had it. And he was like, do you want me to come home? I was like, no, don't come home, because the reality of it is that we can't do anything right now anyway until we start, you know, the process of whatever it is that we have to do. Because at that time, I didn't know what to do. I remember sitting in the car, just watching the people. And I got in my car just in the parking lot. I didn't move. I didn't do anything. And I just remember watching people walk back and forth, back and forth. And I'm like, they don't know I have cancer. They don't know I have cancer. I have cancer. It was like I was screaming on the inside, and I wanted some type of help, but nobody could actually give it to me. And I remember just screaming and hollering, hitting the steering wheel, just in disbelief. It's an unreal feeling, because so many people die from this disease. I remember calling my husband. I remember calling my son-in-law. And I remember asking him, because I could not call my kids. I just couldn't call my kids. I had to call my son-in-law. And he, I told him, I asked him, what is he doing? He was like, nothing. I said, I need you to tell Crystal I have breast cancer. And I couldn't see what his face looked like, but I could hear his voice. And it was like he got caught off guard. I remember calling I thought I had my daughter call my daughter, but my daughter reminded me, my second daughter, that I called her and I told her, but I vaguely remember talking to her about it. The diagnosis of breast cancer, all too real, yet it's not real. I really can't explain the feeling on the inside, but I didn't know what to do. I really didn't. I called my supervisor, who is like my sister. Her name is Rosalind Hurd. She's now retired from LA Unified. She said, just come back here. Because I had nobody to talk to. My husband was gone. My kids didn't live in my house. And I was there by myself. And I did not want to be alone. I just did not want to be alone. So I went back to work. And prior to that, I told my friends and my coworkers that I found a lump. And they was like, okay, go get a check, blah, 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 blah. One of my friends and supervisors was like, it's nothing, it's nothing. And that's the thing. People say it's nothing, because they want to give you hope. But in reality, you're scared because you don't know if it's nothing or if it's something. You want to keep that glimpse of hope that it's nothing. And so when I went to work, I went back to work just to sit and just hang out and talk and all that, you know, just get my mind off of it. And I remember sitting there just crying because I have another supervisor at that time. She was an assistant. Her name was Kathy Bolton, and she's like my sister. And I remember her. She likes to laugh and joke and stuff, but we just sat there and we kind of cried. We just cried. And I also remember when Kiza, she's another coworker, she walked by. And she called me white girl, and I call her black girl. And I just gave her a look, and I just shook my head, and she just came, and she hugged me. She just came, and she hugged me. I can't tell you how important it is to get your mammograms. I only missed 1 year by a few months. I normally go in every November. I never went breast cancer month because I felt like it was too many people. So I always went in November. And this particular year, I decided to go, but I missed November. Then I missed December. And I said, oh, well, I missed this year. So I'll just do it again in November. Well, I just happened to be taking a shower in October. And that's when I found the lump, literally almost a whole year later. And being diagnosed on my son's birthday wasn't, you know, a good feeling, because now I try to celebrate him, but I always remember that day. But then I have to look at it to it a different way, because it's a celebration of life, although, you know, it happened to happen on a special day for one of my children. But I'm going to say this in my ending. I urge each and every one of you, women and men, because men, there's a 2% chance of a man being diagnosed with breast cancer, so you are not excluded. So please go get a mammogram. If you feel anything different, if your breasts are enlarged or if they're in pain, if your nipples are extracting in, anything bleeding from your nipples, go get checked. Let me tell you how to check. In the shower, you'll use a soapy rag, and you put your arm up, and you go from in circles, motions, and then all the way down, feeling for a lump. That's how simple it is. Sometimes you'll feel them, and sometimes you won't. But at least